Now on the screen you can see the picture of the bird Phoenix. Phoenix is a mythical bird. It doesn't really exist. It doesn't really exist in nature, in reality. It is based on Greek mythology, and according to it, it is a long living bird that regenerates, or it is reborn again, and it is associated with the worship of sun. And Phoenix is said, it is said that Phoenix actually obtains new life by arising from the ashes of the of its predecessor. Also, according to some sources, you know, the phoenix dies in a show of flames and combustion. Although there are other sources that claim that legendary bird dies and simply decomposes before born again. So it doesn't die. It is reborn again and again. Now this poem, which is written by Soumitra Chakravarti, is an indication of the beauty of nature emerging from the ugly. Using the metaphor of lotus flower, the poet wants to bring home the fact that beautiful things are not always found in higher places of life or nature. Instead, they can evolve from the lowest places too. This concept can surprise us because we usually look at the highest places for inspiration and beauty, and we totally overlook the lowest places. However, the lotus flower, being the most beautiful flower in the world, comes from what you can say is ugly place. That is because it will be, you know, a place where there is a lot of mud, lot of which is not that tidy. Now let's go through the poem. It was the day after the little bud opened her high eyes, looked around at the bier of elders, long stemmed dun petals trailing various streamers across memories of yesterday, when they shone in fragrant loops over awning and twinkled in black braids. It was the day after the bud opened. Now look at the opening lines. The poet begins the poem with the idea of future. When the little bud opened to a beautiful future, all she saw was the death of long stems and tired petals. Her eyes looked around at the bier of elders. Bier means bier is actually a movable frame on which a coffin or dead body is placed before the burial. So what the young bud, or the young lotus flower which is just born is seeing is the death. It is seeing the death of long stems and petals, which were very active and shining the previous day. They were looking very beautiful the previous day, but today they are dead. The beauty is no more there. Her eyes looked around the bears of elders, long-stemmed, dun petals, trailing weary streamers across memories of yesterday, when they shone in fragrant loops, or awning and tickled in black braids. Now, this reference to the fact that time can destroy this, this is a clear reference that time can destroy beauty. What was beautiful yesterday should undergo changes and becomes ugly tomorrow, and it makes way for newer and beautiful things. Now you might consider a certain thing very beautiful today, but from But in the future, it is going to lose its beauty and it is going to become old. It is going to turn ugly. So what is beautiful today will not be beautiful tomorrow. After reflecting the destructive power of the time, next paragraph, next stanza. She looked up at the young sun, uttered her birth cry. The pallbearers came, hidden in the heap of yesterday. She rode the very path of death, her young gaze fastened. Now, in the first paragraph, in the first stanza, we saw the young bud takes its birth. The moment it takes birth, it looks around. When it looks around, it sees that what was beautiful yesterday was dying before the eyes of this young bud. So she realizes the harsh truth at the very beginning of the life of its life. So it realizes, the young bud realizes the destructive power of time. So the bud actually looks at the sun, and the sun is young forever. She looked up at the young sun, uttered her birth cry, and she started. Birth cry is when the flower, when somebody is young or born, so they make. When the baby makes cry, right? In the same way, she is crying. The young bud is crying, and what does she see? She sees the pallbearers. Pallbearers are the one who carry the dead body or the corpse. The pallbearers came. Hidden in the heap of yesterday, she rode the very path of death, her young gaze fastened. So, while she was uttering the birth cry, she notices the pallbearers, that is the persons who carry the dead body. Now, this is a very dismal picture, but it also tells the harsh truth of life. Now, the young bird has gained wisdom at the birth itself, but the bird looks at the sun and finds the sun very wise. The sun looks at the young bird, but the young bird appears to be pleading for life, for innocence, also for beauty to prevail for longer. On the sun, older and wiser with the wisdom that turns its gaze from the longing of young eyes for life. So the sun is actually looking at the young bird, and young bird is looking for the young bird is longing for life, for innocence, for the beauty to prevail for longer time. Because now the young bird has realized that beauty is not going to stay for a long time. It is only beauty is for today, but for tomorrow it will, because time will destroy the beauty. That harsh truth is understood by the bird. Now the young bird is longing for the beauty to be for a longer period of time. The desire of innocence to linger in a world with wonder long dead. Beauty stretching skeletal arms to the sun whose first rays once smiled on the new world. So it is the young bird is looking at the sun, and it is asking for wisdom. It is asking for life to continue for a more period of time, beauty and innocence to be for a longer period of time. But the nature and the world is not innocent, but is innocent because it has not witnessed the harsh realities of life. The bud actually wishes for the innocence to prevail in the world which is filled with guilt. The first rays of sun had actually smiled on the new world, but now it no longer smiles because the inhabitants of the world have changed their attitudes towards the nature. So the bird is very innocent, but the world in which the bird is existing is full of guilt. So this is the harsh reality which is realized by the young bud. Beauty dies hard. The lotus raises its head from its bed of slime. Two flowers bloom, splash red and yellow over the dust of yesterday, and torn strips of greed with teeth flash in sooth blackened face. Merry eyes dance in the hunt, in dung deep unfolds. In the final stanza, the poet talks about the fact that lotus, though very beautiful, has risen from the bed of slime. Slime means mud. The new flower, two new flowers, which have shades of red and yellow, are splashed across their petals, making them very attractive. This red and yellow shines over yesterday's dirt and overshadows it. The poet moves on to human beings now from the flower. When the white teeth flash in a blackened face and the merry eyes dance in the hunt of something beautiful, the dung heap unfolds, and the outcome and out comes the liberated beautiful lotus buds. Look at the white teeth flash, the blackened face, the merry eyes. These actually describe beauty of an individual who may be black yet happy. The happiness of a person is a reflection of a beautiful mind. When the poet says beauty dies hard, she means that beauty never dies. It comes back in different form. The poet instills in the readers instills hope in the readers with this line. In the same way, you know, a phoenix which is born again, it doesn't die. From the ashes, it rises again. In the same way, beauty also doesn't die. Though the time actually, you know, with passage of time, beauty is destroyed. But beauty is born again, as the phoenix bird is born again and again. In the same way, beauty takes different form. In this poem, the poet at one level explains beauty of nature unfolding from ugliest things. And on another level, the poet actually reflects the general attitude of people to disregard ugly. Even though dung is ugly and despicable, the lotus flower blooms in that mud or in that slime. Like phoenix rises from its ashes, the beautiful bud rises from the dung. The poet also implies that time destroys external beauty, but will never dare touch the internal beauty. By attributing beauty to female gender, the poet perhaps tries to emphasize the fact that female of the species is more beautiful in the world, in different aspects, just not external beauty, but in their behavior and their kindness, fortitude, patience, and love. So in this poem, the poet is talking about the idea of beauty and how beauty, as I have mentioned, is a very subjective thing. Different people have different ideas of beauty. Also, the popular perception is that when we talk about beauty, we only talk about external beauty. But there are other dimensions to beauty which we do not take into account. And also there is a misconception that beauty comes from only certain places or higher places. But even that is also not true. So in this poem, the poet lays emphasis on this idea of beauty, which is both external as well as internal. Now this is the poem. Thank you.